Hello, Ben. Buggered the lights up already. Put my headphones on. Once I've done this, I'll do your challenge one. Yeah, spent a few hours working on it. Still got tweaking to do. Playing in ultra wide, it's difficult getting the layout right, which is why the game screen seems a bit squashed. Yeah, scenario creation can be really frustrating. Quite a sense of achievement when you get it to work though. Dear, just spotted a typo. It was maybe easier to work with, but it wasn't as powerful. I haven't seen Katie at all today, she must be busy doing stuff. Are you on a phone by any chance? Because the autocorrect has got you a second time. Draw, not draw. Ah, DRA, easy to forget. Obviously on a real train it lights up really brightly, so you don't really miss it. Just the whole point, but... Speeding. No, just get away with it. one of my favourite EMUs. I remember when they were introduced. Used to go down to Wessex, what they called the Wessex Electrics. Like everything, it was a lot better in Neckworth Southeast colours. Yeah, no, it comes in Gatwick colours. Hello, Globbits. I would like to find a Network Southeast free skin for it somewhere. Alright then.
Thank you.
Is the video juddering, Ben? Because my game's running smooth, but the preview looks like it's juddering and I'm not dropping any frames. Yeah, I'm not getting it in my game, I'm just getting it on my preview. Don't know what that's all about. Oh, got the speed restriction. Bam, points. Points for speeding. Right, I'll be back in a second. Need to have a quick PMB, a couple of minutes, and then I'll do your challenge. That took a tiny little bit longer than anticipated, but I'm back now. Right, it was the Chatham line, wasn't it? London Victoria to Ramsgate. Weird, one carries the text over and the other one doesn't. Yep. I had a little practice on this earlier and mucked it up, you'll be pleased to know. You'll never get a faultless drive because I don't sign the route for a start. That woke you up. Why is it a pain? Oh, I don't like surprises. Lovely. Doing this scenario. Oh, I've had that in a few places. I was making a scenario for Western Lines of Scotland with a train coming off the branch line, and there's a load of invisible signals there you have to tab past, but you can't see them on the ground or on the guide. I gave up. So Ben and Katie made me buy a Duff Root, did they? Yeah, the Class 800, the white one. Basically a javelin. my way, commuter people. Empty platform. Oh, long before now, when it goes downhill, it caught me out. I wasn't ready for it, and I put some speeding in. Stand back. I hate that. It sounds like an electro star to me. Oh, you meant, sorry, I thought it was talking about this thing now. I'll have to check that out. I didn't think there were any scenarios. Well, there was the on the padded main line, is it? Can't remember. That route's just broken. Always has been. Oh, right, I haven't seen that one. King's Cross route isn't usually that broken. Oh, have a look. Ben, trying to move with a DRA on is exactly what the DRA is there for. Speeding. I knew that was going to happen. Bit rough. tooting my horn a lot. I shouldn't really be doing this, but it's fun. How did you sped at 60 miles an hour? Did you completely forget? Slow tonight, isn't it? No, it's that all day actually, it's been quiet all day. I know he is, I noticed just as I started. I like the flight sim as well. I like all Sims. Almost. Watching the jets fly around isn't fun, no, I agree with you there. But then when I play, I tend to do light aircraft, general aviation. Flights are never usually more than half an hour. I've got farm scene or one of them, either 15 or 16, but I've never really got into it. Can be when you're doing bush flying, but not many people do that. Problem is I won't be doing the old external views very often because I'm too worried about being caught by AWS's. I've got a score to beat. I think it depends on what you do with Elite Dangerous. I mean, I never used to stream it because I was out exploring. And there's nothing interesting in people watching you jump from system to system, ping it, and then move to the next one, and then ping it and move to the next one. So I didn't bother. But if you're into the more combat side of it, then yeah, it's quite entertaining to watch. I like Silent Hunter and all that sort of thing. But I can't see them being very entertaining for people to watch, because most of the time you're just on a map. Either that or you're underwater listening to pings. I think it's a bit of a problem with simulation software in general, actually. It's not a spectator sport. Hello, Kevrev. Yeah, you should try it with an Xbox controller. I've got it on the Xbox One, and I can't fly for toffee. But on my PC I've got an X55, that makes it a lot easier. Still useless at combat. Yep. I've had all the Silent Hunters. Silent Service, I've had that. I've got some more modern ones that came out about 10 to 12 years ago. But again, I can't see it being the most interesting thing for people to watch. Yeah, I play World of Tanks, that's fun, and that's good to watch. I haven't got any mod packs. I tend not to mod games. Tend not to. Sometimes I do. It's sound at whistle ball, doesn't it? Got this one modded stupidly with Armstrong Powerhouse stuff, of course, because everyone has to. Yeah, I bought it in the sale because I was nagged. Yeah, the Destroyer. I never had the Destroyer one. I wanted to get that because they used to work together, didn't they? That would have been fun. I used to play Silent Service on my first PC, the MicroProse game. Oh, too early. And then I was looking in game one day, and I found a big box of the original Silent Hunter with all the expansions, and I bought that. And I played it to death. Yeah, ships, Ben, ships. My Navy friend would be most upset if you called one of his ships a boat. It could have been a certain female streamer type of nag, yes. Viaduct. Ben, you're not a female streamer, mate. Sorry. You didn't nag. She did. Looking forward to seeing the results of her new PC, actually. Thank you. It's a nice machine. I keep toying with the idea of upgrading mine, but it doesn't really need it. Some numbers for you later, Ben, by the way. Is this model actually dual voltage? Oi, I blew my whistle, you cheeky sod. See, that was naughty. I blew my whistle at the whistle board and it gave me an operational error, which I assume is for not blowing my whistle. Thank you. Haven't these games come a long way? Pan up button works. Looks like it might be, look. Pan up works, pan down works, shoes down, shoes up work. Now, if I push pan up now, will I get an ADD? That'll be something interesting to try at the end of the scenario. What is a line vault like? There it is. When we get to the end of the line, I'll try and see if I can put the pan up. Not long to go. On the 357, it's there. You're just trying to make me look, aren't you? I like the blue. I must admit, I don't particularly like this bit. But, you know. Here's another whistle board coming up. Let's see if it robs me of some points this time. If I had to have a favourite colour, it'd be red. but I don't, so near. Right, right at the board this time. Ours are just boring old white. Very boring. No, they were never pink, they're blue. We had blue ones and we had green ones. Or a green one. But they're all white now. There's lots of pink on that C2C DVD though. Because most of the station furniture was pink. Most of the insides of the trains, you had 3570s had green because the original livery was going to be green, and the 3572s were pink on the inside. The light blue on the doors is nice with the dark blue. I like my EMUs. Easy enough to make with a 33 and Mark 1 stock. Hey, there it is, Rochester Castle. I like Rochester Castle. Ding ding. Oh, doors are closed. So this is saying they've actually done, is it? They've ripped up Rochester Station, replaced it with a new one. One of the drivers in that DVD unfortunately died not long after. Poor old chap. Certainly lots of potential for them if you like your stopping trains. I'm a bit confused as to why they bundled the BR Blue pack with it though. It's not exactly a suitable route, is it? Mind you, something they really need. They could really capture the worn out, tired old southern region before Network Southeast. The Microsoft one did that really well. Next time I stream, which may be tomorrow afternoon, I might run that. You'll show me what, Ben? Yeah, no, I know what scenarios there are because I've played a few of them, but I'm surprised they bundled the BR Blue Pack with this route, being such a modern route. But then, as I said, they haven't really got any routes that are suitable. They should make one. Complete with newspapers all over the track. Like that. There's got to be a market for a BR Blue Southern route. I don't understand why everyone's obsessed with the Southern region, but... Right, this is where we end, isn't it? Yes. What happens if I... Fuse up. Fan up. I was hoping to break it. Let's see how well I did. Done that bit of speeding. See how many mistakes he makes on stream. He's actually very quite good at these scenarios, is CK. Yeah, the newspapers were everywhere. It's because they never used to clean the track. Now Network Rail send people down there overnight to clean the tracks, but yeah, toilets used to flush directly onto the track. It was lovely. Lovely walking around the yards. Yeah, now he's really good at some of these. If you look at his scores, that one. There, look. There. I think his performance on stream is put on. He's actually better at this than he makes out. Going back in time. Hmm. That must be easy. Look at Katie's score. I dread to think what that bang was. Hang on a second. Right, so I need to beat Ben, do I? Giving me head code back. What's the Ultra Challenge? Ding! That doesn't make a ding sound. I used to like the bell. Thank you, Tri-Fund. I don't know why it's not been a alert. I better fix that. Ah, oh, there you go. Thank you very much. I'm going to turn that off on BrainBot. I don't like that. So I'm going to log into BrainBot and tell it not to do that. That's rude. Remember how to turn it off. Right, that should be off. Having the bot announce people following in chat doesn't, no, don't like that. Well, I've never driven a 421 in real life. If I had to choose between the slam doors I did drive in real life, it would be those, yes, 310 or 312. They're much more fun to drive. Try an auto brake stop. What I don't like about the auto brake is you had to come in hard, and on the real thing, once you took it off, you couldn't put it back on again until it recharged. On a real unit, that would have been a foul stop. So how many stops have I got to do on this scenario? Yeah, they took the blinds away and painted the glass black in later years, when we had them anyway. I remember being a kid going out of Liverpool Street on a 312 going to Clacton and standing in on the seat so I could look through the glass because the driver had his blind up. I get all nostalgic when I see photographs of 10s and 12s because I think, oh, I remember driving that one. Speeding. They had a Great Eastern. They were the Clacton Express trains. I've actually got the traction manuals for them here somewhere. Units I've driven are 302s around the sidings, 310s, 312s, 317s and 357s. And my favourite has to be the three car regional railway 310 units because they were quick. one of the things I think is quite unfair. There's loads and loads of demand for these old Southern Third Rail units, but no one seems to want the ACs, the slam doors. Alright, they're Mark II stock, but why not? Regional Railways took the trailer coach out of the middle, so they were motored and geared to be a four car, but they were only a three car. And they were very quick. So quick, in fact, that we weren't allowed to pair them up with four car units because it used to do a lot of snatching. So we used to run them as six or nines. We never used to run them as threes. I mean, they drive very much like these, but I don't know, there just doesn't seem demand. It seems that Southern region electrics are very, very popular. Midland region or Eastern region electrics, not so. Don't know why. But obviously people are only going to make what there's a demand for. Alright, Regional Railways took some 310 units, and because they didn't need four coaches, they took the trailer coach out of the middle. So they were a lot lighter. So in turn, they used to be a lot quicker. They were so much quicker that we weren't allowed to pair them up with four car units, because they used to snatch. So we used to run them as six or nines. I think we had about six of them at its peak. That's it. They were motored and geared for four coaches, but they only had the three. And the trailer coach is the lightest one, but it's still just over 20 tons. I'm hoping they let me drive the 387s, but we're yet to see on that one. They do, they're one of the hardest locos to drive that I've seen so far. Fun though. They have, but the Electro Stars and Turbo Stars are good trains. Now they work. They were terrible when they first came out, but there's other companies that do it. Siemens, obviously, Hitachi. We don't know who's got the contract for our latest ones. Probably Bombardier. Hello, Brum. Well, like it or not, Brum, that sort of decision isn't up to us, is it? I never noticed. I did take one out on a quick drive. Are we near yet? Oh, that's a long run. Oh, is this where it gets interesting, is it? Is this where the surprises are? All I remember about the winter of 87 was that storm, and most of the railways in East Anglia were shut for a week while they fixed the damage. That's the problem with overhead lines. see you. Red, okay. The Pompeii refugees on the platform. Ooh, look, fire escape. I'm getting some juddering on my preview, but the game isn't, so I don't know what's causing it. So it's probably something twitchy. It's been a bit juddery on the preview all night. Can you drive a car, Ben? So this will be lost on you probably, but much like when you're comfortable in a car and you know what a car's doing just by the way it feels, it's the same with a train. You know when the wheels are slipping, you know when it's performing right, when it's not performing right, and that's the sort of thing that a simulator can't give. So a lot of the train driving is the feel of the track, the feel of the train and all that sort of stuff that you get with experience. It's almost like it's the same as when you're used to a car, it's almost like it's an extension of yourself. And without full motion simulation, that's the sort of thing you don't get. It's like with professional pilot simulators. They have the motion because the pilots rely on it. It is, but it's done with your brake handling. A lot of people think that drivers learn to drive in a simulator and then go out and drive the real thing, but it's not the case, because you can't learn it in a simulator because of all the feedback you get from the train and stuff like that. So you have to do, it depends on the company and the route, but you'd have to do about 200 hours of driving with an instructor, driving passenger trains and whatnot, or freight trains if you're a freight man, before you can even take your exam, and that's when you learn your route. When they give you a new route to sign is when it gets interesting, because you have to do that off your own back. So you get cab passes and jump up front with drivers and go all over it for however long. They gave me 2 weeks to learn from Barking to Liverpool Street. But the driving course, the actual out with the instructor when I did my driving course, was it was a 6 month course to convert from the depot onto mainline driving, and about 4 months of that was out driving with an instructor. I assume I'm waiting for a train. It was just sitting there waiting for me. I wish you could do this in real life. God, there's two of them leaving. Oops. I'm not really trespassing. No, sorry. Not me. I did it once for a little while, and then they took me off the controls because I started spinning the wheels. But there you go. That was at the Colne Valley. early for a 12 set, or late, I suppose. Firing is an art, and so is driving them. That's why it took them so long to learn, I think. I wouldn't want to do that anyway. I like coming home clean. One of my best memories of that sort of time was in, what would have been 1984. My best friend's mum took us to Reading for the day so we could ride on a HST. And on the way back, the guard told us to hang around. So when we got to Paddington, we hanged around and he took us up the front, spent some time with a driver and a second man. They took us in the engine room and all sorts of stuff. It was great. Remember that to this day, clear as a bell. And I'll probably lose points for this, but the best thing about these old trains was... it was emergency, shutting them down. Right, when this is finished and I've got my score, I'm going to have to leave because I've got to be up in the morning, so I'll be going to beds. Yeah, I think I got my silver medal. Look at that! That's just not fair. He must have cheated. Cheat. Potentially in the afternoon, yes. Depending on how I feel, I'm up early, so I might not be in the right frame of mind to do it, but we'll see. So, I'm off. Watching, and I'll see you all later.